Patrick Xavier worthy today.
Yep.
Pretty efficient out there. What he had. Just taught me through your explanation to him before the game, how you tried to get him set for his first NFL moment, and how he went out there next.
I mean, he's so cool, calm, and collected, like, all the time. Like, you would never even see the excitement on him. But, I mean, he goes out there and makes plays. Obviously, we want to continue to use him more and more. But I thought he had a great day today, making big plays and big moments. It was good to get the whole offense going and kind of seeing where everybody's at.
Hey, Patrick, it's a game of inches, right?
Yeah.
What did you think of that last play? You know, it was their offense. And watching the replay and seeing how it all...
Yeah, no, definitely nerve-wracking. I mean, because it looked good from my angle on the sideline. But then the first view you saw, you could see the cleat. That's a great football team, and I'm sure we'll see him again at some point in the playoffs. So now we're happy with the win now, and he's got to wear white cleats next time. That's my advice for him.
What is your perspective of Xavier Worthy passing touchdown you had to him? Is he, like, take me through your progression?
Yeah, no, it was a it's definitely, like, you can see it was a bust in coverage. I mean, from where the corner was playing, I, like, looked out there. And I saw how he was playing, and I was like, I think he's playing cover two, but the safety's not there. And so I was going to, like, how he was playing, I was like, I'm going to alert the go anyways, just a one-on-one matchup. And the moment he played cover two, I think everybody else played cover two, too, and then there wasn't a safety there. I just fired it to him, and he scored a touchdown. So definitely a bust in coverage, but that happens early in the year, and I just had to take advantage of it.
Is the route he's supposed to run on that play?
Yeah, that's definitely the route he's supposed to run. He was going to run a go route. I was going to probably go there anyways if it was man, just because I was going to try to match up. It was off coverage man. He could get a good release, but it wasn't. So he was just running wide open.
I don't want to ask you about Pop's touchdown. What do you see on that?
Well, I mean, obviously, he got to right at the goal line, and I felt like I could just give him a little shoulder in there. And I don't know if I gave him much, but I feel like I moved him off of directly in there, and then he fell through. But, I fell through, too, so I feel like I scored a touchdown as well. So I feel like I should get at least, like, half a touchdown.
Have you been like that before, and did
Andy? I did it before in, I think, 2018 versus the Colts maybe, and O-lineman hit me from behind, and Coach Reed told me never do it again, so luckily we scored, and I didn't get hit by anybody else, so he probably will tell me to never do it again.
What made you do it?
I mean, just we were struggling in the red zone, so I was just trying to find a way to get in. That's a tough defense, especially down there, and we needed that touchdown, so I just put my body on the line to get in there.
Whether it's Worthy this year or Rice last year, so every year you guys are plugging in a new piece that's crucial. How are you guys able to those guys and what's the key to evolving the offense?
Yeah, I think it's just, I think everybody accepts everybody in this offense, and they learn so much from Trav. They pick his brain, and they listen to him talk to me, and we build all throughout the year. And you can see Rasheed just kind of picked up right where he left off last year. Xavier made some big plays. And so it's just, we're going to continue to build and build, and hopefully get Hollywood back and see what this offense can really be.
Do you feel like Xavier, he had the two touchdowns, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
He had an impact on the game beyond that?
Oh, 100%. I mean, just having him out there, it just opens up stuff. I mean, you saw when he's out there, they're playing shell coverages. It's getting guys like Trav, and it's getting guys like Rasheed open underneath. And that's what's so great about this offense is we're able to do all of that. And that's when we're at our best. And so, like I said, we get Hollywood out there too. It's going to be tough for defense to decide who they want to cover.
Where he scored, is that one where you guys call it, you're like, this one feels good in this spot? Looks like one play for the offensive lineman to get downfield. Is that one that you, right from the get-go, you thought might go?
I knew it was going to be good. I mean, you never know. Just with all the blocking and all the different stuff, I thought it was blocked very well. I thought the offensive line did a great job. The tight ends did a great job of kind of sealing their guys off. Rasheed had a crucial block. And then once you get one in space, man, he can make stuff happen. And so, those plays, we ran one similar in the preseason, and he almost went to the house, and then he ended up getting in there this first drive.
Patrick, how do you feel about Brady's extension today? Mm-hmm. He played well tonight, had some critical catches. Mm-hmm. How do you feel, about the player he's become to be?
Mm-hmm. No, I mean, Noah's always been a great player. I mean, he makes plays every single time he gets the opportunity to. He's playing behind the greatest tight end of all time, so he doesn't necessarily get every single route called to him. But when you go to him, he makes the play. I mean, a couple of great catches today, tough contested catches. And I'm happy for him because he's one of those guys that's in the locker room and just does whatever you need. He'll play special teams, he'll block, he'll catch the football. He's just the guys that you need in order to go out there and win Super Bowls.
We're going across from Sam. Go ahead, Sam.
Patrick, obviously, Rasheed's got a better grasp of the playbook than he did this time a year ago. But what else do you see that leads to his development?
Yeah, no, I think first off, confidence. I mean, just being in the offense and knowing. And then I think more than anything is when you know the offense, you can play faster because you can just play free. And he does. He knows the offense. And so some of those times we might have been a little hesitant at the beginning of last year, he just goes. He just goes, trusts his instinct. I get him the football, and then he makes plays after the catch. And so I want to continue to make him push down the field more. I think he can do that. The defenses weren't giving that to us today. But I think if he can continue working on that, and he could be one of the best receivers in the league.
After the third and 12 play, you had two defenders right in your grill. I wonder if you could just describe how you got away from them. And also, that's the play you passed by Dawson, or if you have any thoughts about that.
I mean, I'm deceptively fast. That's what I've always said. Like, I'm not fast, but I'm deceptively fast. So I think it's the way I run, people take bad angles. So I got around there and made the throw to Trav downfield. He continued to work. He wasn't even supposed to be on that side of the field, and he continued to get over there and get open. And so, no, but the pass, Lynn Dawson, man, I mean, what a true icon, not only for the Chiefs, but the NFL, of passing the football in that age. The fact that I'm passing him just now, it shows how great he was at the quarterback position, and what a great person, too. I was so happy to get to meet him so many times and just him share advice with me. And so it's truly an honor to me. I got the football. It'll be in my room, in my trophy room, around the top of the mantle.
Last couple, Matt. On the interception, what did you kind of see there? Was that just a matter of just being in the grasp?
Yeah, no, it was I probably should have just thrown it to Trav, and then I tried to get a little greedy and get back to Rasheed, and he was open, and just like the way I awkwardly was trying to throw the football, I couldn't get what I wanted to on there. It would have been a tough throw because Roquan was in the area, but I thought I could have made the throw. It just didn't make it, and he made a great play and put our defense in a bad spot, and they were able to hold him to three, which obviously was very big in the end.
You had a reception tonight, Patrick. So
yeah.
That was a big play because then if that would have been picked off, they would have taken the ball over right there.
Yeah, no, it was if I could have just got it over the guy, it was going to be a first down. I could already see Trav about to block Roquan. Rasheed was going to catch it. But the kid made a great play. I think he was number 23. He jumped up, made a great play, hit it in the air. And more than just, I think, just getting the interception, I wanted to catch it so the clock would run down to 2 minutes and run some time off for our defense. And I mean, I know I got 2 yards, but I thought it was pretty good catch. So maybe get Coach Reed to throw me a pass here somewhere.
Thanks, Patrick.